North Korean farmers prepare the land for rice planting, a staple food in the country. This footage was filmed last month by the United Nations World Food Programme, one of the few aid groups allowed to operate in North Korea. It is warning that recent climate conditions mean 40% of the population are now in need of urgent food assistance.
What is clear is that the succession of bad drought, heat wave and floods this year has badly impacted the crop production.
The report from WFP and the UN's Food and Agriculture Organization says those most at risk are young children and pregnant women. They warn of families being forced to cut meals or eat less. It's a warning that's being heard at the highest levels. President Trump spoke by phone to South Korean President Moon Jae-in last week and supported the South's desire to send humanitarian aid.
It would have the effect of cracking open the door from the current stalemate in talks. President Trump expressed a total support in that regard.
This despite North Korea's suspected short-range ballistic missile tests earlier this month, a violation of UN resolutions. South Korea's unification ministry says they are working on a plan to send aid, but no specifics yet.
North Koreans are going to start.
For some experts, concerns of food insecurity may be valid, but the extent of the crisis is unclear.
Something bad is definitely happening. However, they should also keep in mind that food prices at free market, free food prices are stable. And it sort of does not agree with the idea of famine just about to erupt.
WFP has 11 supported food factories in North Korea and provides nutritional assistance to some 770,000 malnourished women and children. Its report is based on information gathered during the assessment in country last month and in late 2018, but WFP does acknowledge some data is provided by North Korea itself. Experts fear that could be open to manipulation.
The US has been skeptical of humanitarian aid for North Korea in the past because they say that Kim Jong-un is perfectly capable of feeding his own people. He just chooses to divert millions of dollars into his nuclear and missile program. But Trump's softening of that stance could signal a return to aid shipments as an incentive for Pyongyang to come back to the negotiating table. Paula Hancock, CNN Seoul.